Hello friends. So friends, today we will learn one very interesting and important topic in management accounting, that is ratio analysis. We will learn the meaning of ratio analysis, its importance, its limitations, how to do interpretation through ratios and classification of ratios. So let's get started. First, what is ratio analysis? Ratio generally shows the relationship between two particulars in numbers. So here we will put particulars of firm's financial statements and try to show the relationship between them in numbers. Not only that, but we will also analyze these ratios to check profitability, to check liquidity, to check efficiency, and to check solvency, so that it will prove helpful in future decision making. So what is the importance of doing this ratio analysis? Why it is required? First, it identifies strengths and weaknesses of a business as it checks the profitability, liquidity and solvency. So business owners can simply know what are the strengths and weaknesses of a business. Next, it simplifies financial statements as it puts the details in very simplified manner. Next, it helps in decision making as it shows the financial position of a business. It also helps in financial forecasting and planning and works as a future guide. It helps business to know its place in current market competition, and different ratios also play an important part in cost control. To get the maximum benefits of ratio analysis, we need to do interpretations. Ratios are only numbers if they are not interpreted. So to do the interpretation, we can compare our ratios with other firms' ratio, with our own past year's ratio, with ideal ratios, and with other ratios. Ratio analysis also has some limitations. First, it is based on historic data, because we use financial statements particulars to find ratios, and generally financial statements are prepared for the year ended. Second, it ignores external environment. It does not take current market situation, inflation, recession, government policies, etc. into consideration. Third, comparisons of ratio is not that easy. We may compare ratios with other firms' ratio, but it is hard to get the data of those firms, and accounting policies may be different. If we compare with our own past ratios, then problem may occur that in past we might have used some different accounting policies, and now we are using some different accounting policies. And ideal ratios and proper standards of comparing these ratios are not available. So actually comparisons of ratio is not that easy. And fourth, ratio analysis may direct in a wrong way sometimes, because ratios themselves don't make any decision. Managers need to do so. And if the managers are not well knowledgeable or not well experienced, they may end up taking a wrong decision. Now, moving on to most important topic, that is classification of ratios. So generally we classify ratios on two bases. First, classification on the basis of financial statement, and second, classification on the basis of nature of the ratios. If we classify on the basis of financial statements, then there will be three types of ratio. First, ratios of profit and loss statement, that will show the relationship between particulars of profit and loss statement only. Second will be ratios of balance sheet, that will show the relationship between particulars of balance sheet only. And third will be mixed ratio, which will show the relationship between particulars of both profit and loss statement and balance sheet. And if we do classification on the basis of nature of the ratios, then there will be four categories. First is profitability ratios, which will disclose the relationship of profit against sales and investment. This category covers ratios like gross profit ratio, net profit ratio, operating ratio, expense ratio. In terms of investment, we can find return on capital employed, return on shareholders fund, return on equity shareholders fund, return on equity share capital, and earning per share. Second one is leverage ratio. It will indicate the level of debt against several particulars of financial statement. It will cover proprietary ratio, debt equity ratio, capital gearing ratio, long term funds to fixed asset ratio, and interest coverage ratio. To check the position of liquidity in the business, we find liquidity ratios. It will cover current ratio, liquid ratio, acid test or quick ratio. And the last will be activity ratios. Fourth category will be activity ratios, which will determine how efficiently the assets of the company is being used by the management to generate maximum possible revenue. This category will cover stock or inventory turnover, debtors ratio and debtors turnover, creditors ratio and creditors turnover, fixed asset turnover, working capital turnover, total asset turnover and net asset turnover. Okay, so this is the basic of ratio analysis that we learned in today's video. So hopefully you all must have understood. So that's all we have for you in this video. See you in the next one. Bye.